The earliest evidence of glue was found in the cave paintings of Neanderthals in Lascaux, France. These ancient artists wanted their art to last, so they came up with an ingenious method of mixing glue with paint to make the cave paintings resistant to moisture on the cave walls. In the 1930s, the boom of the chemical and plastics industries led to the development of a wide range of adhesives. The advent of World War II led to even more growth of this industry, paving the way for chemically engineered adhesives, such as neoprenes, epoxies, and acrylonitriles. Since the introduction of glue to the consumer market in the 1940s, many more highly specialized glues have been made. Even waterproof glue has been developed, as well as other highly specific glues, including glues used for the construction of space shuttles. The raw materials used for the production of glue might not be what you imagine. Manufacturers typically obtain the bones and tissues of animals from slaughterhouses, tanneries, and meatpacking plants. The world's largest glue manufacturer is a dairy company known as Borden Company. The animal remains used as raw materials for glue may include ears, tails, scraps of hiding, or skin, scrapings from fleshy hides, tendons, bones, and feet. Glue is not only made with animal products, but also with fish detritus. The manufacturing process of bone glue, hide glue, skin glue, and fish glue differ only slightly. The process begins with the washing of the hide, skin, bones, and other animal parts. After this, the materials are soaked in water to soften them. This softened and clean material is known as stock. The stock is then passed through a series of water baths, where the concentration of lime is progressively increased, causing the skin or hide of the animal to swell and break down. Finally, the stock is put into boiling hot water and stirred, a process known as cooking the glue. Cooking this mixture at the right temperature and duration ensures that the stock breaks down into glue that is of industry standard quality. After the cooking process is performed 3 or 4 times, with an increase in temperature or pressure with every successive step, the resultant liquid is referred to as glue liquor. The glue liquor is removed after formation and then reheated again to thicken it. When the material is cooled down, it looks like a jelly. This form of glue still has one drawback: potential impurities. To remove the impurities and make the glue clear, chemicals like alum or acid are added, and then egg albumin is added. These chemicals make impurities precipitate to the bottom of the glue. To make the glue into various forms, such as brown, white, and clear glue, additives must be added. At this point, the glue is a weak, runny liquid. Its concentration is increased by placing it in vacuum evaporators and dried. The glue can then be chilled into sheets or blocks, then suspended on nets to dry and concentrate even further. The glue is then poured into different tubes, containers, and sticks for commercial use across the globe. It may be easy to overlook the significance of glue, but it truly does help to hold the world together.